Hello dear students, my name is Prajakta and this video is for grade 9 science chapter 1 matter in our surroundings and this is topic 4 latent heat. In this video you will be able to understand the concept of latent heat of fusion and latent heat of vaporization. So what do you mean by the word latent? Latent means something that is present but is invisible or hidden. I'll explain you all this with the help of an example. Do you all know that you leave your fingerprints on everything you touch? Even if your hands seem clean, your fingerprints will stay behind on the surfaces you touch, but they are invisible. So yes, fingerprints on the surfaces can be considered as latent. So how is this word latent related to heat? Let us understand this with the help of a video. This same video you must have seen in my previous lecture, that is of topic 3, state change. If you have not seen that video, I have put the link in the description. So first, kindly go through the video and then you may come back to this one. So this video is about change of state from solid to liquid. That is, we have ice, and ice on providing heat, it will get converted to water. Now here students, the important thing is that you will also note the temperature change that is taking place. So when heat is provided to solid ice, the temperature will slowly increase till it reaches the melting point, which is 0 degree. Now at this temperature, ice is getting converted to water, but the temperature here is not increasing. It is remaining constant. Once all the ice has got converted to water, only then the temperature will slowly rise up. So students, you must have observed that even if the heat was provided to ice, but as soon as the temperature reaches 0 degree, which is the melting point of ice, the temperature did not rise. Instead, ice got converted to water without the change in temperature. So where does this heat energy go? The heat energy that is provided is utilized to overcome the intermolecular forces of attraction between the particles of solid to change it into liquid. Matlab, jo heat hum provide kar rahe hai, wo energy kyun use ho raha hai, kis liye use ho raha hai? To break down, to overcome the intermolecular forces of attraction between the particles of सॉलिड. इसलिए हमें वो हीट चेंज, जो टेम्परेचर चेंज है, वो नहीं दिखता है. एंड दिस हीट विच इज प्रोवाइडेड डज नॉट शो अप एज अ राइज इन टेम्परेचर, और इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन ऑल्सो से इट रिमेन्स हिडन. और इसका ही नाम क्या है? वी कॉल दिस एज लैटेंट हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन. स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाई फ्यूजन? Fusion means nothing but melting. So as the temperature or as the state change is from solid to liquid, we call it as latent heat of fusion. So let us understand the definition. The latent heat of fusion of a substance is the quantity of heat, the amount of heat that is required to convert one unit mass, which can be 1 kg or 1 gram of a substance, from solid to liquid at its melting point without any change of temperature. So ye jo bhi change ho raha hai from solid to liquid, it is at the melting point. Jo temperature, jo substance, jo melting point hai wo substance ka, वो टेम्परेचर पे हो रहा है. एंड एट दिस टेम्परेचर द चेंज ऑफ हीट or the change of temperature is not seen, and hence that is called as latent heat of fusion. So students, ice at 0 degrees Celsius, we can say that when ice reaches at 0 degrees Celsius, it will absorb heat. Absorb heat करेगा, मतलब in other words we can say वो substance, जब भी कोई substance से heat absorb होता है, मतलब वो substance क्या होता है, cool हो जाता है, है ना? जब भी heat निकल जाता है कोई substance से, तो क्या होगा वो substance cool होगा. And hence as ice at 0 degree Celsius can absorb heat, it will result into cooling effect. वो cooling effect देगा. And then after all the intermolecular forces of attraction, the particles have overcome, only then it will get converted to water, which will be at the same temperature. And hence we say that ice at 0 degree Celsius is more effective in cooling than the same quantity of water at the same temperature. So in other words, we can say ice ज़्यादा अच्छा cooling effect देता है than water, which is at 0 degree Celsius. Now let us understand this latent heat for liquid to gas. Again, we have a similar type of a video showing the state change from liquid to gas. You will here also notice the same thing, that is the temperature change when the state is getting changed. So now this is liquid, that is water. It is getting heated. So slowly the temperature is increasing here, students. Yes, but as soon as the water will reach its boiling point, which is 100 degrees Celsius, that time just notice what happens. Now 100 degrees Celsius, the temperature is remaining constant and water is getting converted to water vapor. But here the rise in temperature is not taking place, and this will happen until all the water has got converted to water vapor. Now, as soon as the water gets converted to water vapor, now the temperature will slowly rise up. So here again the same thing, the energy, where does it goes? The heat energy, yes, it is utilized to overcome the intermolecular forces of attraction between the particles of liquid. Yes, ये कहाँ पे use हो रहा है heat energy? क्यों temperature constant था 100 degrees पे? Because ये जो भी heat provide हो रहा था, that was getting utilized, that was getting used to overcome या to break the intermolecular forces of attraction. और इसलिए हमें वो change of temperature नहीं दिखा. ओके, सो नाउ लेट अस गो टू द डेफिनेशन. लैटेंट हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन. नाउ व्हाई वेपराइजेशन स्टूडेंट्स? बिकॉज द चेंज ऑफ स्टेट इज फ्रॉम लिक्विड टू गैस. एंड लिक्विड टू गैस जो भी चेंज ऑफ स्टेट है उसे हम क्या नाम है, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द प्रोसेस? इट इज वेपराइजेशन. सो द लैटेंट हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस इज द quantity of heat required to convert one unit mass of a substance from liquid to gas at its boiling point without any change of temperature. तो ये जो भी होता है चेंज, ये कभी होता है बॉइलिंग पॉइंट पे ही होता है. And that time the change of temperature is not seen, it remains hidden. And hence the name latent heat of vaporization. So students, water which is at 100 degrees Celsius, it will absorb heat. वो heat absorb करके किसमें convert होगा? It will get converted to steam. Or in other words, we can say that steam will have more amount of heat at 100 degree Celsius. क्योंकि वाटर ने हीट सारा एब्जॉर्ब करके वो किस में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है, स्टीम में, एट द सेम टेम्परेचर. तो स्टीम के पास क्या है, ज्यादा हीट एनर्जी है. एंड हेंस वी से दैट स्टीम एट 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस कॉजेस मोर सीवियर बर्न्स दैन बॉइलिंग वाटर एट द सेम टेम्परेचर. मतलब स्टीम जो 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे वो ज्यादा बर्न्स देता है. इफ इट फॉल्स ऑन आवर स्किन इट गिव्स मोर बर्न्स एज कंपेयर टू बॉइलिंग वाटर विच इज एट द सेम टेम्परेचर. सो दिस वॉज लैटेंट हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन. नाउ लेट अस गो टू द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ लैटेंट हीट. द एसआई यूनिट इज जूल per kilogram. Joule because it is in the form of energy, heat energy, and we are calculating the latent heat per unit mass, isn't it? It was per kg. So hence the SI unit is joule per kg. The latent heat of fusion for ice is 3.35 into 10 raised to 5 joule per kg, and the latent heat of vaporization of water is 22.6 into 10 raised to 5 joule per kg. Okay, so latent heat of vaporization of water is 22.6 into 10 raised to 5 joule per kg. Matlab, water 22.6 into 10 raised to 5 joule per kg itna heat absorb karke wo steam mein convert ho raha hai. Matlab, steam ke paas obviously zyada heat hai. And hence it causes more severe burns. So with this, we end this video. I hope you understood the concept of latent heat. Thank you so much for watching.